गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम हियर टू एक्सप्लेन क्लॉजेस। स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव हर्ड अबाउट क्लॉजेस एंड फ्रेजेस, बट देर इज डिफरेंस बिटवीन बोथ ऑफ देम। फ्रेजेस आर द ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स, दे डू नॉट हैव सब्जेक्ट एंड वर्ब, वेर एज क्लॉजेस are group of words that contains a subject and a verb. I repeat, a group of words that contains a subject and a verb is called a clause. A clause forms a part of a sentence. A clause has complete meaning and has incomplete meaning. A clause, it is a group of words that contains a subject and a verb. Clause, it forms a part of a sentence. Clause, it has complete meaning and has incomplete meaning. Now let's understand clause. I met a lady who had a blue umbrella. If you see students, in this sentence there are two clauses. First, I met a lady, and second, who had a blue umbrella. If you see, I met a lady, it has complete meaning. I met a lady, it has complete meaning. And second, who had a blue umbrella? Who had a blue umbrella? It does not have complete meaning. And both are group of words. I met a lady, four words. Who had a blue umbrella? 5 words. And both had, here I met a lady, I subject, met a verb. Here, who conjunction had, it is a verb. So both are clauses. Here, I met a lady, it has complete meaning. Who had a blue umbrella does not have complete meaning. So clause, it has complete meaning and has incomplete meaning. See the another sentence. The teacher reported that all the students had completed the test. Here also two clauses. The teacher reported, one clause. Second, that all the students had completed the test. The teacher reported has complete meaning. That all the students had completed the test, it does not have complete meaning. So group of words that contains a subject and a verb and forms a part of sentence, it is called a clause. A clause has complete meaning and has incomplete meaning. Thank you, students.